Lord, my heart is yours. It all belongs to you. I give you all the glory. Yes, I love you. I worship and adore. I want to tell you more.
Worthy,
I love you.
You are worthy.
I love you.
Hallelujah. Ooh, thank you.
Praise your name, Jesus. Thank you,
Yeah.
don't want that blood. Hallelujah. That blood will never lose its power. That blood will never lose its power. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. We thank God for the blood today. We thank God for the blood. Hallelujah. Amen. We're not going to prolong the time. But the good part is not to come yet. The good part is the word. It's always the word. Made it feel good to give God some praise. Hallelujah. Come on, put your hands together. Hallelujah. If you know the blessed, it works. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. Let the church shout. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. We're not going to prolong the time, but we have a speaker that's going to bring the word. Amen. How many are expecting a word?
Amen.
You came for a word, didn't you? It's the word that's going to give us life and that more abundantly. Come on and stand to your feet. Hallelujah. Put your hands together. And welcome the speaker of the hour, Minister Ashley Hope, with a hearty praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Say, preach, girl, preach.
Preach, girl, preach. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Doesn't it feel good?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Yes.
It's so good in the office.
Yes,
feel good when I hit the pulpit. It's been feeling good all day.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
The Lord is with us.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The Lord of hosts is with us.
Yes, Lord.
The Lord of hosts is with us.
Hallelujah.
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 Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
We have a few scriptures. Some of this may even sound familiar to you after a while. The Lord is taking me back to this. I was telling Sister Holloway, the Lord is crazy because he gave me the end first, then gave me the rest of it.
Oh,
hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
We're going to roll with it.
Yeah.
All right. Hallelujah. All right, let's go to Ephesians 6. We'll start at verse 10.
All right.
Then find 2 Corinthians 10, and we're going to start at 3. Then go to 2 Chronicles.
All right. Come on.
20.
Yes, yes.
And 17. When you have it, say amen.
Amen.
If you're still looking, say wait a minute.
Ephesians 6.
You said amazing?
Was the first one?
Ephesians 6.
And 10.
It says, finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God,
yes,
that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil.
All right, come on.
For we wrestle not against flesh and blood,
yes, yes,
but against principalities, against powers,
yes,
against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places.
You,
wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God,
yes,
that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all to stand.
Hallelujah.
Stand therefore, having your loins girt about with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness,
mm-hmm,
and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace.
Yes.
Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked.
Yes.
And take the helmet of salvation, and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all saints. Now go to 2 Corinthians 10. I'm going to start at verse 3.
Yes.
Says, for though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh.
All right.
For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal.
Yes.
The weapons of our warfare are not carnal.
Come on.
But are mighty through God to the putting down of the strongholds.
Uh-huh.
Then go to 2 Chronicles. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Verse 17. Ye shall not need to fight in this battle. Y'all got it? 2 Chronicles 20:17.
Yes, hallelujah.
Ye shall not need to fight in this battle.
Yes.
Set yourselves. Mm-hmm. Stand ye still.
Yes.
And see the salvation of the Lord with you, O Judah and Jerusalem.
Hallelujah.
Fear not, nor be dismayed. Tomorrow go out against them, for the Lord will be with you.
Hallelujah.
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 Speak now, Lord, in Jesus' name.
In Jesus'
you may be seated.
Amen.
If I were to have a topic, it would be the fight is coming to you. But God said, stand still.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
And God said,
hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Ooh, thank you, Jesus.
If we look around today, in the last month or so, the Lord has, the world, excuse me, has been thrown into turmoil.
Yes.
The Lord has allowed a plague to come on the land.
That's right.
Yes.
Called COVID-19.
COVID-19.
Or coronavirus.
Yes.
Also known as the Rona.
Uh-huh.
The Rona.
Corona.
And the world has gone crazy.
Yes.
They're going shopping like they did back in 1999.
Uh-huh.
When they thought the world was going to end once it clock hit midnight. That's why Prince said that's why he's going to party like tonight is 1999.
Lord have mercy.
And the world, just as they did in the last few days here in America, they did the same thing in 1999. Shelves were empty. They got all these things. They done stocked up. And what happened? We went into 2000 and nothing happened.
Come on.
God gave us another day. That was the greatest thing that did happen. And they went crazy for nothing. Yet our seats are still empty.
Yes. Hallelujah.
God is trying to get their attention. Certain church doors have closed because of regulations that have come out saying no more than 250. And these churches that hold 1,000 said, well, that means we're going to have to close our doors and just stream live. Some said it don't matter. We're going to put sanitizer in. We're going to sanitize the sanctuary and y'all can still come. But if you're sick, stay home.
Yes. All right.
Be conscious, be wise. But we still going to keep our doors open.
That's right.
But yet through all the craziness, our seats are still empty. Because people are scared.
That's right.
People are living in fear.
Yes.
Because of a virus that this too shall pass.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Bible says the weapons of our warfare are not carnal. What are weapons? First of all, the weapons are guns, knives, bombs, and words. Those are things that hurt the flesh.
Yes, yes.
Yes.
But our spiritual weapons is prayer.
All right. Come on.
First one is prayer.
Prayer.
The next one is fasting.
Fasting.
Then we have the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God.
Yes.
Then we have the name of Jesus and the blood of Jesus.
Go ahead.
In our obedience.
Yeah, obedience.
All right? The name of Jesus has power.
Yes, yeah. Come on.
It has authority.
Yes, it does.
It has influence.
Come on.
It has dominance.
Yes.
And it commands respect.
Yes. All right.
When you call on the name of Jesus, demons tremble.
Amen.
When you call on the name of Jesus, demons have to flee.
Yes.
When you call on the name of Jesus, the atmosphere must change because the name of Jesus carries power. Power over everything. Power over everything. Power over everything. It is supreme for the supreme. It has jurisdiction. It carries weight. My name doesn't carry weight. Yes, everybody say, yeah, you a Hulk. I can tell. You look like him. You act like him. You a Hulk. Hulk might carry weight in some instances,
right.
But it don't carry that much weight.
That's right. That's
the name Hulk ain't going to get you into heaven.
That's right.
So it ain't got no weight.
That's right.
Holloway ain't got no weight.
That's right.
Blandon don't have weight. Ware don't have weight. None of our names carry weight. But when you carry the name of Jesus, the name of Jesus carries weight. It carries weight, which is why demons tremble.
Yes.
And he can heal the sick soul, the sin sick soul, and natural diseases. The name of Jesus can heal natural diseases. The name of Jesus can cast out COVID-19. But we got to use the name of Jesus in order to get rid of it. Church, this is our time to shine in the middle of turmoil because we have the name of Jesus. We ain't got no reason to fear COVID because we got Jesus. It brings on his blood. The blood of Jesus has power. It washes away sins from the past, for the present, and in the future. Because we have an advocate with the Father who is Jesus Christ, the righteous. Hallelujah. It washes away sin from the past, for the present, and in the future. It protects us. And it is the standard that is raised. Isaiah 59:19 says, so shall they fear the name of the Lord from the west and his glory from the rising of the sun. When the enemy shall come in like a flood, the spirit of the Lord shall lift up a standard against him. It shields us. The blood shields us. His spirit shields us. It consecrates us. And it gives us eternal life. I'm not going to break down everything. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But when it comes, when the fight comes your way. See, maybe I do need to break it down. Let me go back. Let me be obedient and not rush through this. Principalities is a state, office, or authority of a prince. High places, a temple or altar used by the ancient Semites and built usually on a hill or elevation. Might is strength or force or power. The armor is a covering. The armor is a covering. So take on, let's see. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. So now we're in Ephesians, we're breaking it down. And it says, put on the whole armor. The armor is a covering. For as many as been baptized into Christ have put on Christ. Christ is your covering. Hallelujah. Verse 14 says, stand therefore, having your loins girt about with truth. Your loins is the upper and lower abdominal regions and the regions above the hips. The truth is Jesus. According to John 14:6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. So cover yourself with Jesus. The breastplate is usually a metal plate worn as a defensive armor for the breast, a vestment worn in ancient times by a Jewish high priest and set with 12 gems bearing the names of the tribes. Righteousness is God. According to Genesis 14:17-20, 15:6, in Hebrews 6:20. You can go back and watch the video for that. Hallelujah. But we need the breastplate of righteousness, which is God. So we've got all this covered with God. And your feet shod with the preparation. Shod means foot gear, a type of shoe covering. So your feet got to be covered too. With the preparation of the gospel of peace. The gospel of peace is the gospel of Jesus Christ. And having the shield of faith. The shield is the first line of defense. The shield is the first line of defense. When arrows are being shot, shields go up.
That's right.
Any sci-fi movie you watch, every spaceship has a shield. To keep all the guns and the bombs and everything they're shooting at them from destroying the ship. In this fellowship, our shield is the word of God. But having the shield of faith, we can go to Hebrews 11 for faith. Having the shield of faith, your faith guards your soul. It deflects the fiery darts and can incapacitate the enemy.
Amen.
Roman shields had some type of weapon on the middle of it. So if they pushed, you was going to get hurt. So they push against you. You can push against Satan with your shield.
Yes.
The shield of faith. And having the helmet of salvation. The helmet now is a head covering. Mm-hmm. We've covered everything now from our breastplate, from our shoulders down to our feet, but now we have to cover our heads.
Right.
Having the helmet of salvation, and salvation is deliverance from the power and effects of sin. Perseverance from destruction or failure.
Come on.
So the devil likes to protect, likes to fight your mind.
Yes, right.
He likes to fight your mind. He likes to trick you into things.
Come on now.
That's why we have to have the mind of Christ.
That's right.
Come on.
But while you're striving to have the mind of Christ, the devil is subtly trying to put things in your mind to get you to turn away from him.
That's right.
And when you call and it seems like he's not answering, that's when the devil starts to see he ain't saying nothing to you. That means he don't love you no more. He ain't listening to you. Why you keep praying? He ain't listening to you. Why you keep going after him? He's not listening. God ain't there. He done left you alone. You have to say, he said he'll never leave me nor forsake me. He said when I call, he will answer. Now you have to have the sword of the Spirit. The sword is a weapon such as a cutlass or a rapier with a long blade for cutting or thrusting that is often used as a symbol of honor or authority.
Yes, yes.
An agency or instrument of destruction or combat. The use of force or coercive power.
Yes, yes.
Hallelujah.
That's what the sword is.
Yes, yes.
The sword of the Spirit is the word of God, spoken and expressed.
All right.
That means the sword is Jesus.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Because it is the word of God. In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God. Then the word turned around and had the business to become flesh.
Come on, come on.
And dwelt among us and gave us his name. And his name is Jesus. Now we have to use our weapons. After we put on Jesus, we got to use our weapons.
Yes.
Prayer is an address or a petition to God or a conversation.
Uh-huh.
Supplication, it says, with all prayer and supplication.
Uh-huh.
Hallelujah.
Thank
with
you.
All perseverance and supplication for all saints. So prayer is an address or petition to God, a conversation. Supplication is to ask humbly and earnestly of. Perseverance is continued effort to do or achieve something despite difficulties, despite failure or opposition. Steadfast, push through, overcome, keep going. That's what perseverance is. So praying
always
with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance. That means don't stop. Just because it got hard, don't stop. Just because somebody said something to you, don't stop. Just because they got on your nerves, don't stop. Just because the word hit you upside your head, don't stop. Now, when the fight comes to you, the best thing about it is you don't even have to fight. You can just wrestle. Anybody ever seen a wrestling match? They have them in this circle. And you can't get them out of the circle. The goal is to get your opponent out of the circle. I ain't talking about WWE. That's fake.
Oh, okay.
I'm talking about real wrestling.
Right.
When they're wrestling, the thing is to get your opponent outside of the circle.
Yes.
Get them off the square.
Yes.
If you will. Get them out of their comfort zone. Get them out of the safe zone.
Yes.
And the devil comes to get you out of the safe zone.
Right. Right.
Amen.
That's right.
The ark of safety is the blood of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
It is the church, the body of Christ.
Hallelujah.
When you're under the blood, you're in the body of Christ.
Yes. Yes.
And the Satan comes in to knock you off your square.
Yes.
He's coming and he's pushing.
That's
and he's trying to push buttons.
Right.
And he's shooting fiery darts.
Right.
But the weapons of our warfare are not carnal.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Amen. He'll send people that he knows you don't like.
Right.
He'll send situations he knows will knock you off your square.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
COVID has come,
come on,
to make the world realize who Jesus is.
That's right. That's right.
Amen.
But it has also come for the saints to make sure they know who
that's
he
right.
is
that's
too.
Right. That's
right. Amen.
And to give us the opportunity to shine in this lost world.
Right.
But some of us are letting COVID knock us off our school.
That's right.
Say, well, we're covered by the blood and COVID can't touch us. That's not true.
That's not true.
I've already gotten a report that somebody has contracted COVID in the church. So now what?
All right.
Your faith has to be strengthened.
That's right.
Yes.
Because God said, I am the God who healeth thee.
Yes.
Yes. Hallelujah.
If he heals all diseases,
yes.
Yeah, I might contract it, but God is a healer.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
He said, ye shall not need to fight in this battle.
All right. Jesus. That's your name.
You don't need to fight in this battle.
Hallelujah.
You may be wrestling to stand still.
Right.
So you don't go out of your circle.
That's right. Come on, preacher.
Thank you, Lord.
He's pushing.
Yes.
And trying to knock you out.
Yes.
But your fight is to stand still. Fight means to contend in physical conflict, either singly or in a war or a battle.
All right.
To wrestle means to contend with an opponent by grappling and attempting to throw, immobilize, or otherwise defeat him, depending on the specific rules of the contest.
All right.
To fight means to strive for, to campaign, or to contend for success. To wrestle means to struggle or strive.
Come on.
Or to fight. But God said he'll fight for us.
Yes.
So all we're doing right now is wrestling.
That's
come on. Yeah.
He's fighting, but we're wrestling. Stay in your circle. Why is he fighting? The devil wants you to bow. He wants you to bend.
Yes,
he wants you to break.
Yes,
he wants you to worship him. Because he seeks glory.
That's right.
He wants God's glory. That's why he tried to set himself above God. But God said, stand still. In the midst of turmoil, God said, stand still.
Hallelujah.
In the midst of peril, God said, stand still. Therefore, tell the devil, I refuse to bow. I refuse to bend. I refuse to break formation. If my formation is to bend, to bow in worship of God, I'm going to do that. I'm not going to break formation. If my formation means my hands need to be lifted, I'm not going to break formation. If my position is to fight with my shield up, I'm not going to break formation. I'm not going to step out of the will of God. I'm not going to take off my armor. If I take off my armor, I step out of formation. I refuse to step out of formation. The devil wants us to live in fear.
Yes, that's right.
But God said, fear not.
Fear not.
Because I haven't given you the spirit of fear.
That's so.
That's what he said.
He said, fear not.
Fear not.
Because I didn't give you the spirit of fear.
Right.
So I refuse, devil, to live in fear.
Hallelujah.
You may make me nervous, but I ain't going to stay that way.
Because
all I got to do is call on Jesus. And every time I call on Jesus, you got to get further and further away from me. Because at the name of Jesus, demons tremble. At the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. In heaven and in earth and in things under the earth. So when I call on Jesus, devil, you got to go. COVID, you got to go. Flu, you got to go. Common cold, you got to go. Cancer, you got to go. I refuse to live in fear.
Come on now.
God said the battle is not yours. It's mine. I got this. Watch me work. His word said the Lord shall fight for you and ye shall hold your peace.
Yes. That's the word. Come on.
Yeah, the devil fights me at night. He fights me at night. Tries to take over. He fights me at night. But I don't get upset because God said, hold your peace. Call on my name and hold your peace. Yeah, I hate the devil, but I ain't got to get out of myself to get rid of him. If I get out of myself, I end up in him and he gets to take over me. So I'm not going to get out of myself. I'm going to stay in Jesus. And I'm going to use my armor and my defense system. And all I got to do is plead the blood and call on his name.
Hallelujah.
Psalm 91:10 says, there shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. We need to be speaking this. There shall no evil befall me, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. We need to be speaking this. There shall no evil befall me, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. I can go into DSA and say, no evil shall befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. I refuse to believe that COVID has made it into the building of DSA.
Hallelujah.
I refuse to believe that COVID comes into these doors.
All right, if it does,
it has to go.
Hallelujah.
So that means when they walk in, if they come in with the virus, since our Lord is a healer, he's going to heal the disease and cast it out. Why? Because the word says, there shall no evil befall thee.
Oh, that's
right. Neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling.
Oh, yes, Lord.
We got to learn how to speak the word.
Yes.
You got to learn it first.
All right. All right. All right.
You got to learn it.
Yes.
You got to live in it.
Yes, right.
You got to wrap yourself in it in order for you to use it.
That's right.
Amen.
If you don't have the name of Jesus, you have no business using it.
Yes,
that's why the ones that didn't have business using it, when they tried to cast out Satan, they said, Peter I know, Paul I know, who are you?
That's right.
They didn't have no business using the name.
That's right.
Paul was so powerful, his shadow was healing folks.
Yes,
that's right.
His shadow. He didn't even touch him. The dark place that casts off when the sun is shining on you. The shadow.
The shadow.
His shadow.
Heal
folks. And all he had to do was walk by. He just walked by. That's how much power we have. We have that same power. We have that same spirit that Paul had. Greater works than these. We can be doing the same thing and more. We bear the name. We bear the blood. We bear the spirit. We are his body. We are the sons of God.
Lord have mercy.
We need to be exercising our power outside these walls.
All right.
Not just when we come in. Outside these walls. But if you get injured, if you get sick, if you step out the circle, Exodus 15:26 says, and said, if thou wilt diligently hearken to the voice of the Lord thy God, and will do that which is right in his sight, and will give ear to his commandments, and keep all his statutes, I will put none of these diseases upon thee, which I have brought upon the Egyptians. For I am the Lord that healeth thee.
Glory.
I am the Lord that healeth thee. I continue to heal.
Yes.
I am the Lord that healeth thee. Any sickness that comes upon you, you tell it, I am the Lord that healeth thee.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Psalm 107:20 said, he sent his word and healed them and delivered them from their destruction. His word is Jesus. God sent Jesus. God sent himself in the flesh to heal every manner of disease, natural and spiritual, because he came to heal the sin-sick soul. So nothing can stand against him. We say, tell me who can stand before us when we call on who? God's great name. What's the name?
Jesus.
So we have no reason to fear.
That's right.
No reason to fear.
When they ask you, how can you remain so calm when the world is in peril? I got Jesus.
I
got the Holy Ghost. I have his blood. I have his name. Therefore, I have power and authority over Satan. I have power and authority over illness. I have power and authority over my situation because I bear his name. All I have to do is call on Jesus. I put on my armor, which is Jesus. I have on my breastplate, which is Jesus. I have on my helmet, which is Jesus. My feet are shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace, which is Jesus. When I pray, I'm praying to Jesus.
Right.
When I cast out demons, I'm using the name of Jesus.
Yes.
How can you do that? You have to be baptized into Christ in order to put on Christ. Well, I've been baptized Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. You didn't put on Christ, you put on titles. And that won't help you. That won't get you in the door. You need the name of Jesus. You need the baptism in Jesus' name in order to put him on.
Come on now.
All right now.
Tell them, Philippians 4 and 7, and the peace of God which passes all understanding shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus.
Said so.
It can't keep you if you ain't got them.
All right.
It can't keep you if you ain't got them on. It can't keep you if you ain't walking in them.
Come on.
It can't keep you if you ain't living right.
Come on.
You got to be living and walking in Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. If you don't have his mind, it can't keep you.
All right.
Tell them, I got the Holy Ghost.
Thank you, Jesus.
I got the Holy Ghost. I know I got the Holy Ghost. I got the evidence of speaking in tongues as the Spirit of God gives utterance. I'm not talking off my head. I'm not making it up. The Lord speaks through me.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. I have his blood.
Thank you, Jesus.
And I have his name. Because I've been baptized in Jesus' name. I've been filled with this Holy Ghost. I have no reason to fear. Yes, I may get scared, but I don't have reason to stay in it because I got Jesus. I might get nervous, but I still got Jesus.
That's right. And that's enough.
You have to be sober.
Amen.
You have to be vigilant because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion walketh about seeking whom he may devour. He wants you. Satan hath desired to sift you as wheat. He wants to take you out. He wants you to live in fear. He wants you to bow. He wants you to walk away from God because God said he'll never leave you nor forsake you. So he wants you to walk away. Are you so good that God put you up for trial? Said, have you considered my servant?
Job.
Hallelujah.
Can God trust you with trouble?
All right.
Help me, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Can he trust you with trouble?
Thank you, Jesus.
We say we have faith, but are you exercising it?
All right.
You say you have the Holy Ghost, but are you using it?
All right.
Come on.
Are you letting it lead you and guide you into all truth?
Yes. Well.
You say, I put on Christ, but are you taking them off?
Hallelujah.
And putting them back on?
Thank you, Jesus.
Or are you keeping them on?
Thank you, Lord.
We can't fight if we take it off.
That's right.
That's right.
He said, put it on. There's no place in there where he said to take it off.
That's right.
Put on the whole armor of God. There's nowhere after that that says to take it off.
Yes.
That means we need to live in our armor.
All right.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
We need to walk in our armor.
All right now.
We need to sleep in our armor.
Amen.
We need to work in our armor.
All right.
It needs to be our favorite outfit.
Yeah. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
It's my hat. It's my shirt. It's my pants. It's my skirt. It's my shoes. It's my underwear.
All right.
I put on the whole armor. I'm buried in Christ. That means all of me is covered. Put on the whole armor of God. Never take it off. If you take it off, you put yourself in the state of backsliding.
That's right.
Jesus. Oh, glory.
If you slide back and never slide forward, when he comes back, it'll be too late.
That's right.
And your armor will be gone.
Yes.
That's right.
Thank you, Jesus.
Don't get caught out here naked.
That's right.
Don't get naked.
Don't get caught out here naked.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
You don't have to fight, y'all.
All right.
Hallelujah.
I was wrestling with the devil last night, periodically, throughout the night.
Mm-hmm.
I had already anointed my doorposts.
Mm-hmm.
I anointed my windows.
Thank you, Jesus.
Pled the blood against them before I went to sleep.
All right.
Still had to wake up in the middle of the night to wrestle.
Thank you, Jesus.
Bless her, Lord.
Bless her, Jesus.
But guess who won? And guess what I told him? You already lost. I don't know why you keep coming back. I ain't scared of you. You can keep waking me up all you want to. I ain't scared of you. He tries to do sneak attacks and try to attack me in my sleep. And every time the Lord wakes me up, I keep saying, I don't know what the problem is. You have already lost.
That's right.
You cannot have me. I will not bow. I bear the blood of Jesus. And in the name of Jesus, you have to get up out of here. The blood of Jesus is against you. You have no business here. You have no authority here.
Hallelujah.
There's nothing here for you. I don't know why you keep coming trying the same stupid stuff.
Amen.
Every time you try, you lose.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
God already fought my battle. He's still fighting. So I'm going back to sleep. He tries again. I got to say the same thing again. You already lost. You lost 5 minutes ago. Why are you trying again, stupid? I have the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus is against you. I bind you in the name of Jesus. I cast you back into the pit of hell in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I ain't got to get upset.
That's right.
He said, hold thy peace. Thou shalt hold thy peace. The Lord shall fight and thou shalt hold thy peace.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
All I got to do is call on the name of Jesus.
That's it.
That's it. But I got to bear the name in order to call the name.
That's right.
Amen.
Yes, he answers to his name for anybody that calls. But in order for me to have authority over the enemy, I must bear his name.
That's right.
That's right. Got to have his name.
I can't get nothing. Evangelist Barney talked about it. How the things that was happening with her husband. And how the insurance money only came to her because she had his name.
That's right.
She had that piece of paper. She had the life insurance policy.
All right.
And the other wife who was technically illegitimate because he was still married, couldn't get nothing. Because Evangelist Barney had his name.
That's right.
I can't inherit heaven if I don't have his name.
That's right. That's right.
I can't inherit the blessings if I don't have his name. I can't walk on the streets of gold if I don't have his name. I can't walk into my mansion if I don't have his name. I can't live in that gated community with gates of pearl if I don't have his name. You must have his name. Neither is there salvation in any other. For there's no other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. If you have not the name, now is the time to get the name. It's time for a name change. It's time for a name change. This plague is showing us that God is soon to come.
That's right. That's what's showing.
Yes, it is.
It's time for a name change.
Amen.
If you've been stepping out on them, now it's time for you to get back in them.
Thank you, Jesus.
And renew yourself. Get your soul renewed. Get your spirit renewed. Get the Holy Ghost renewed within you.
That's right.
Now is that time. Come on, preachers. Now is that time. If you've been dealing with sickness, if you've been dealing with the devil, if the Lord has just been taking you through stuff and you don't know what to do, now is the time to come get prayer.
Thank you, Jesus.
Now is the time to come get prayer. Yes, I handed them sanitizer because we still have to be smart. Have faith, but don't be stupid.
That's right.
We believe God, but we still have to believe in cleanliness as well.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. If you need healing, he said, I am the God that healeth thee. I am the Lord your healer. I sent my word and healed your disease. I am the God that heals all manner of diseases. We learned last week that every part of your body has ears. So you can speak to it and be healed. But if you need help, the preachers are here for your healing. Hallelujah. Come on, pray, saints. Hallelujah. If you need renewing in your spirit, now is the time. If you need to be restored, now is the time to come. Hallelujah. Come on, pray, saints. Hallelujah. 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 Come on, pray, saints. Pray till they walk in these doors. Hallelujah. Pray till the Spirit of the Lord falls down once again. Hallelujah. He's been here all day. If you want to get your touch, it's time for you to open your mouth. Hallelujah. Come on. Pray, saints. Worship him, saints. Hallelujah. It only works when we're all with one accord. Glory. 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 Come on, pray. Pray, saints. He's moving even right now.
Right now, Lord. In Jesus' name.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
Look.
Glory.
Glory.
Glory. Glory. Come on, pray, saints. Pray, saints. Pray, saints. Pray, saints.
the name of Jesus, we ask you, the Lord,
pray, saints.
Take the pain.
Glory.
Take the inflammation.
Come on.